while we were collecting data in the background, there just wasn't the strength and fortitude at certain levels of the university to drive that into a process that the entire university could both be part of and learn from.
So I think when we started looking at this process as a whole, trying to decide, you know, how were our metrics going to be built and things like that, we of course you look around at what other universities are doing to see, you know, how have other people tackled this, and the answer is everybody tackles it in their own specific way. That's really idiosyncratic to that university. Culture and the mission of the university and all these things. So what we had to do was actually sit down, build those metrics as a group with referencing the strategic plan that we put out, and to try to create a process that was right for TU.
So there were really four places on campus that data came from. The Institutional Research Office has lots of data on enrollment trends and tendencies, retention and graduation rates. So that office produced that. The assessment office produced data on program reviews and student learning outcomes. The colleges themselves then produced data that largely dealt with course level data and data about the faculty and some of their work at the college level. And then the departments themselves generated quite a bit of data regarding the course offerings that they offer as part of their majors, as well as course offerings for their service courses, some more faculty level data, and some more data of that nature that dealt a lot with things like how they were engaged in the community through internships or externships or other things like that.
Interestingly, I think this process has been more confirmatory than exploratory. I think across campus, the people that were affiliated with some of these areas of campus that were either really strong or that are shorthanded, or some of our programs that don't have as strong of enrollment as other ones on campus, the people that were close to those programs knew that. I think what we were missing was an across the university look at this. And so in a lot of ways, I don't think the end result has been surprising.
What I think was so important about this was that we knew that some dramatic things were going to have to happen, but as a member of the Board of Trustees, and I certainly know as a member seeing the administration operating, they wanted change, but they wanted change that was based upon data. And so it makes the change, while it's still painful for everyone that has to change along with it, it makes it, you understand, it's not personal, it's fact-based, it's something that will truly make this university better. And that's why I'm so comfortable with this PPRC process. It was not done, in fact, some people probably have done things that maybe were not in their best interests, because they felt, as TU citizens, and I really mean that as an important statement, that we are all citizens of TU, and so at our heart, we want this university to be viable for 50 years and more.